one might expect, especially in the beginning, usually a few years. After reading or hearing about twin flames and their perfectly balanced energies, many people think it would be like a fairy tale, do you find your twin flame and live happily ever after kind of thing. It is not. It is a perfect relationship, but it needs some work from both the partners. Twin flames are two souls, people who were created in the beginning from one single soul unit with male and female aspects together. This singular soul unit was a unified energy sphere of male and female, that split into two souls creating the twin souls. A soul is made of energy much like electricity and is in essence a blue flame. This is why they are called twin flames. Each of these two souls after the split was a new and complete soul. Just as cells divide and become new complete cells, or a hologram is cut into pieces and each is the entire picture within it, identical to the original picture. Each soul has all the things necessary to be a complete functioning soul. The souls were polarized, one embodying mostly the male energy and one mostly the female energy of the original sphere. Each also retains a part of the other within them. They may be different on many levels, but on many other levels they are also exactly the same. The yin and yang symbol is one of the best illustrating this, with each side holding a small dot of the other. There are, as I see it, five main phases of a twin flame relationship. Everyone understands a twin flame relationship differently. And there are no clear timelines or specific periods for any of these phases. Each differs for every twin flame couple. I'm giving you this information so that you can understand this relationship better. There are no rules. And there is no one size fits all in a twin flame relationship. Each relationship will be unique, just like each couple. Having said that, here are the four main phases that usually resonate with all twin flames in some way. Phase 1, the preparation. This phase comes before you meet your twin flame. But I'm counting it as one of the phases as it is very much a part of your twin flame relationship. What happens in this phase? Karmic relationships. There are one or few seriously devastating relationships. These begin with strong emotions and end painfully. These are called karmic relationships. Emptiness and strong desire for the one. After you've been through the karmic relationships, you'll have a very deep yearning or desire to find the one. At this point you will desire meeting your perfect love, whose image you will carry in your imagination or in some cases in dreams. This image is of your twin flame, although you probably won't realize it at this point. This happens because your soul knows your twin flame is coming. Phase 2, the meeting, a glimpse of heaven. This is the phase when you meet your twin flame for the first time in this incarnation. You might try to resist at this point, but you will fall for him / her anyway. Then comes a short period of perfection. This is what I like to call a glimpse of heaven. What happens in this phase? The first meeting, you'll meet your twin flame in unusual circumstances or at some unexpected place. A place where you would not expect meeting your life partner / soulmate. You'll find this person somehow special at this point. Even though you might not even think of them as a partner. The initial attraction, you'll soon find yourself being attracted to your twin flame. You might not be ready for a relationship because of the karmic relationships that you've been through, and so you might try to resist this attraction. You'll fall anyway. Deeply in love. A short period of the most perfect relationship that you've ever experienced. After the initial attraction, you'll find yourself in a deeply romantic relationship. It will seem perfect in every possible way. You'll find all that you want in your partner and much more. This is what a twin flame relationship is actually supposed to be like. And this is what it becomes, if not better, after you get through the problems that surface in the next phase. This short period makes you aware of the perfection of yourself and your twin flame, and deep brings back the memories that were always deep within you. This makes you want to go through the next phase, which is a little tough. It's like a trailer for what your relationship is going to be in phase 4, after the reunion. Phase 3, the dance, resolving what is known as the karma. This is a tough one. It starts after you've been in a relationship with your twin flame for a while. In this phase, all the accumulated negativity and lower emotions come to surface. This seems difficult to go through at the human level, but it is actually a truly divine process in which the twin flames get deeply cleansed with each other's help. This lets them achieve higher energy levels so that they can ascend in bliss together. This is also the phase where both twin flames get spiritually enlightened. This is when they search and find the spiritual reality. If you're currently in a twin flame relationship, you're probably in this phase, as this is the period of time when you usually begin finding information on this. What happens in this phase? Arguments/fights. This phase brings many arguments and fights. This happens because the negativity that each partner is carrying within, usually at a subconscious level, comes to surface. The twin flame will reflect this like a mirror, and so you'll think it's in them, when in reality it's in you. This begins the deep cleansing process. The blame game. Each twin flame sees their own negativity and clutter in their twin flame. Also, deep-seated fears and frustrations surface. So you think it's happening because of the other and start blaming each other. You consciously might not realize it, but this is clearing all your clutter, which is a good thing. The runner and the chaser. The arguments and the blaming causes a lot of confusion, because usually the spiritual process is not understood by the conscious mind, as we are conditioned to trust logic more than feeling. One twin flame, at this point, takes the role of the runner, which is usually the man. The runner tries to avoid the partner and run away from the relationship. This happens because the runner doesn't consciously know what is going on and feels like he's losing control. In our defense system, we build up huge walls to protect ourselves. This happens as soon as we meet someone who will help us to repeat our patterns of abuse, abandonment, betrayal, and/or deprivation. His happens because those people feel familiar. Unfortunately, in childhood, the people whom we trusted the most, were the most familiar, hurt us the most. So the effect is that we keep repeating our patterns and being given the reminder that it is not safe to trust ourselves or other people. The other twin flame, now, becomes what I call the chaser. Usually the woman, the chaser is spiritually more aware than the runner at some level and tries to chase or run after the runner. The chaser usually wants some sort of commitment at this point. This happens as the chaser subconsciously or consciously wants to get over with this tough phase so that both of them can reunite. The chaser is deeply shocked and hurt by the running and unexpected behavior of the runner. This is when they feel the need to understand what really is happening, and so they start searching or reading about it. This usually leads to the enlightenment of the chaser. The runner becomes spiritually enlightened too, either through the chaser's conscious effort, or by receiving a soul shock when the chaser gives up and goes away from the runner twin flame. The phase gets stretched longer the more the runner runs. Ultimately, the runner does return and the karma is finally fully resolved. Phase 4, the reunion. This is the phase of the reunion. This is when the split soul becomes one again. This happens first at the level of the soul and then in the physical plane. Yes, that's when you get married, unless, as in rare cases, your physical reunion is not a part of the plan. The reunion happens when both the partners are fully aware of the spiritual reality. Phase 5, eternal bliss, being love. This is the happily ever after phase. Both twin flames will be fully spiritually aware and enlightened at this time. There is perfect love and harmony. The twin flames now enjoy their sacred love and intimacy, and have the power to create whatever they can imagine. The world truly becomes their canvas. and they paint it with the colors of love. At the end of their journey on Earth, they ascend together and go on to experience more, just like they always have, in other worlds and other planets, in this universe and beyond, together, in love, joy, and peace together, in eternal bliss.